Hi there, this is a technical breakdown video of the STEM Audio Ecosystem Hub device. The Hub device is actually a very interesting device in the sense that you only need it if you have multiple audio endpoints in a room. So if you have a single STEM audio device in your room, you can just go ahead and plug that device directly into your PC or whatever you're using to conference. However, once you bring in multiple devices in the room, what the Hub does is it just centralizes all the audio of those devices and represents them as one single channel. So what you'll do is you'll basically plug the hub into your PC or whatever interface you're using, and that's going to actually send all the audio from the room and collect it as well. In our connector panel, all the way on the right, a RJ45, and that is your Dante connectivity. This is going to be used in case you want to somehow connect your room into a Dante network. It will again represent all of the devices in the room on a single Dante channel. Next up, we have our USB-B connector. It's just the USB connector you're going to be using to plug this into any kind of computer to run your video conferencing. After that, right in the center, we have another RJ45 connector, and that's the most important connector. It's what we use to both power the device, so make sure that whatever you plug this into supports PoE+, or that you have a PoE+ injector, and it's what's being used to communicate with all the other devices in the room. All the way on the left of the connector panel, we have our terminal connector. This is for external speakers. So in the case that you want to use your own speakers in the room, you'll use this connector to plug into some kind of amplifier or amplified speakers, and then you can pump that sound out through those external speakers. And then finally, important to mention, just like every other STEM audio device, we have our Kensington lock right above over here so that you can lock this device down. Now, the last thing I'd like to mention about the device is it's actually designed to be either placed in a cabinet, has a very low profile, or more importantly, to be mounted on the wall right behind a TV monitor. So it's got these two keyholes in the back, screws into the wall, push it in, click it in place, and it's out of mind, out of sight. This device does not have to be out in the open room again, since there's no microphones or speakers on it. That's it. In order to plug it in, just like any device, place it where you want to place it, plug it into the network, give it a couple of minutes to boot up, then go ahead to the platform and set the room up. This will be covered more in section 2, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching.